life.
Ah.
Oh no.
Ah. Are we all? Can you hear me now? Testing. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Looks like I forgot to press a button. Sorry, everyone. I forgot to press a button.
Yay.
Oh, man. Can you believe that? I've actually done round one. Sorry. You've all missed it. Oh, yeah. Can you believe it? Damn. No, I didn't forget. I had everything and I was talking. I was giving out the questions. I was saying hello to everyone.
You did all your hellos, didn't
wow.
you?
Wow. Shall we start again, Faye?
Yeah.
All right.
Sorry.
Okay, so we've got to say hello to Doc Holliday, Sarah and family, Nikki, Ramon, Dave and Dee, Hildy, Kate and Steve, Unborn. We've got Andrew. We've got William. We have Two Wired, Jerry, Kate and Jawad, CT. Jonathan, Willow, Sam and Andy. And then Steve Ladden actually was late. So when you say, what kind of service is this? I just forgot to press the button. PDS, hey. Wow, sorry about that. So at least for next time, hey, Gaming Llama, I know I've got to press a button on the other one.
Which basically says go live.
Yeah, go live. Anyway, hey, welcome. So let's crack on then. Four minutes late.
Over just to there. You do that?
No.
You can't?
No.
All right.
Like that?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And it seems to be going the right way.
Yeah.
Yes, well, absolutely. You've got to come in for pop, haven't you? Got to come here for pop.
You do, Andrew.
I don't want to take any more of your time, Andrew. You've been good. Right, round one. Pens and paper at the ready. And welcome all those new people. Hey, Paul and Dawn. Yay.
Yay.
And Five Star. Yay. An opening assortment. Question one. How many X chromosomes do women have? How many X chromosomes do women have?
I'm drinking tea at the moment, so I might need a few wines in me. I've got an assortment of wigs.
Pens and papers at the ready. That's it. I can't believe I was talking away, thinking you could all hear me. Oh. And then we saw it flashing in the top right-hand corner. Go live. We're thinking, well, we are live. Clearly we're not. Wow. Question two, how many revolutions per minute did 7-inch records make on a record player? How many revolutions per minute did 7-inch records make on a gramophone or record player? Yeah, no, I click start streaming on OBS, and then it started, but I should have clicked on the top right-hand corner of the YouTube page of the studio, yeah.
We could have done half the quiz.
We could have been halfway through by now. Question three, what colour is the middle vertical stripe in the Belgian flag? What colour is the middle vertical stripe in the Belgium flag? Quick PDS, just send a text to Skyhopper. He'll tell you. Yeah, 2Y, quick. Anyway, if this all goes smoothly, that'll be good enough for me, Andrew. Mm-hmm. Be quite happy with that. Question four. In April 1997, which actor was was appointed ambassador of the Bahamas to Japan. In April 1997, which actor was appointed ambassador of the Bahamas to Japan? Here's one for you sci-fi people. Paul. Question five. What colour is Spock's blood? What colour is Spock's blood? No. Spock. What colour is his blood? Andrew's a trekkie. But we all found out Andrew's a trekkie, isn't that good? Right, we're moving on for round two to geography. Just a nice straightforward geography. Question one, what is a piece of shallow salt water separated from the deeper sea by coral or sand called? Hey Raf, how you doing? What is a piece of shallow salt water separated from the deeper sea by coral or sand called? We're all good, brother. Mm-hmm. If you're staying, grab a piece of paper and a pen. Test yourself. Question two. What is the state capital of Louisiana? What's the state capital of Louisiana? You guys need to be getting these ones over there. Mm-hmm. Be very embarrassing not to know these sort of simple questions about your home nation. Mm-hmm. Here's another tester. Question three. Which US state capital is known as the Mile High City because of its elevation above sea level? Which US state capital is known as the Mile High City because of its elevation above sea level? Yes, well, you do work in IT, so I wouldn't expect anything else. You're probably like saying it and it's typing it out for you. It's like a personal assistant.
Oh, sorry, Jane.
I'm family. Hey, Smithy.
Hello.
Hope you're well. Tuss face. Just checked her phone.
I know. Sorry.
That's all right. We're only on round two. and like I say, Raf, you can't know all the questions in a quiz. It just wouldn't be a quiz, would it? Might learn something. That's what we all try. Here's one. Question four. What is the capital of Croatia? What is the capital of Croatia?
I better say hi to Mum.
Yes. Hello, Jennifer Henderson.
Hi, Mum.
Hope you're well.
I know you're not going to type, but...
No.
Yeah.
Hope you're there well with your 72 cats. Hope they're keeping you warm. Yes, exactly. There's always something for everyone, Andrew. Just got to wait and be patient. Question 5. What is the name of the highest mountain in Japan? What is the name of the highest mountain in Japan?
We've been to Dubrovnik, haven't we?
We have, yeah.
It's lovely.
Round 3 is an audio round. Something for everybody in this. Some of it is tricky. Well, it would be tricky for me, but probably not tricky for everyone. So let's see. Oh yeah, leave a like. That'll be decent. We like likes. Okay, right. So first two on the audio are jazz, really great, smooth. So just give me the artist for number one. Here it comes.
I'm in with all 8 cats.
Just wait for the here we go. Who is this? That? Which artist? Moving on to number 2, which artist is this? It gets better though, Jet Gaming. In a minute we go 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s, 2010s. Don't know anything about jazz either, Faye and I, but there's a few in there who do, so that's cool. Right, so we're moving on now. The next two are musicals. Okay, so I'm going to play you a song. You just tell me which musical it came from. So here comes number 1. That's how me and Faye sing when no one's watching.
Gazing down on the Jungfrau,
from our secret chalet for two,
let us drink little mine
in the moonlight to be nine.
Oh, the joy of a dream come true.
Tricky one, that. But there'd be something for everyone. Trust me. Just wait. Here comes the second one of those. Yeah. So which musical is this?
Every time I look down on this timeless town, whether blue or gray be her skies, whether loud be her cheers or whether soft be her tears, more and more do I realize I love Paris in the springtime. I love Paris in the fall.
Right, that is the tricky jazz and musicals out of the way. So now we go 1960s. Which artist is this?
Got a big job on.
Oh, let's get rid of the adverts. That is from the 60s. Here we go with the next one. This is from the 70s. Which artist is this?
Zoom it in my heels and ting. Them checks that were hip and ting. Chew them the law and ting. We'll have them going and ting. Now pop, no style. I'll strictly roots. Now pop, no style. I'll strictly roots. See me from the road and you not call out to me. Do you see me in my pants and ting? See me in my altar back. See me give your heart attack.
Was the 70s. Now we're on the 80s. Willow, we're 80s. Keep your 100% record. Who is this? I'll just skip the adverts. Your 80s. Here comes the 90s. 90s CT. 90s. Mm-hmm. No giving out the answers in the chat, please. Who are? There we go. That was the 90s. Car, we're cracking through them now. Here we are now onto the 2000s. Here's the 2000s. That's a copyright strike, if ever I saw one. Don't you reckon, CT? All the, my audience in North Korea, Iran. Anyway, here we go. And here is the one from 2010s. Which artist is this?
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. We're more like the way we rock it, so don't stop.
Hey, Blurry.
Nothing I can see but you when you dance, 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 girl. Good, good creeping up on you, so just dance, 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 girl. All those things I...
That is the audio for this week. Moving on, though. Round number four is food and drink. Food and drink. Question one. Americans call this vegetable an eggplant. But what is it known as in the UK? Americans call it this vegetable an eggplant, but what is it known as in the UK? You just dance away, Andrew. That's all you got to do. Just move your shoulders. Thank you. Thank you, Hildy. Yeah, put it in Polish and mark it yourself. If you're sort of anywhere close, then... Here comes number two. Another favourite in the USA, zucchini, is called what in the UK? Another favourite in the USA, zucchini, is called what in the UK? You're going to find out, aren't you? And it works well because obviously, we don't call it that, so both sides are trying to work it out. Is she cheating, CT? Give her a poke. Question three. Tempura is a fish or vegetables deep fried in batter, best associated with which country? So tempura is a fish or vegetables deep fried in batter and is best associated with which country? Question four for you, Blurry. Question four, mocha is a coffee usually flavoured with which substance? Mocha is a coffee usually flavoured with which substance? Yeah, yeah, it all exists. No glitching in my quiz. It's all straight up. You are a bit of a nutter, to be fair, but in a good way. And question five, blinis are stuffed pancakes best associated with which country? Blinis are stuffed pancakes best associated with which country? Right, I'll keep this ticking along so we don't run over too much. So next round is science and nature. Science and nature. Question one. Infrared light has a wavelength that is too long or too short to be visible for humans. So infrared light has a wavelength that is either too long or too short to be visible for humans. So it's a 50-50. Too long, too short. Hopefully this week I don't get any questions wrong as the quizmaster.
Actually, I could
have
an Irish coffee.
Yeah, we like Irish coffee. You want to try a Blurry's coffee? Or question two, how many sides does a heptagon have? How many sides does a heptagon have?
How blurry was.
Yeah, it's Joanne.
It's Joanne, isn't it? Yeah. They do, yeah. Best coffee.
How many likes we got anyway? Oh, can't really tell. We'll have a look after. It's very exciting. Right. Here we go. Yes, Colombian. I've got some Colombian coffee, but instant. Question three. Which is longer, 3 kilometres or 2 miles? Which is longer, 3 kilometres or 2 miles?
I click that open.
This?
Yeah.
Over that?
Well, no, not the chat, is it? I don't like seeing the two screens.
That's it.
Annoying.
Okay. Bless you. Thank you. Right, question four. What are the small bones that make up a backbone called? What are the small bones that make up a backbone called?
Mm-hmm.
That sounds nice, PDS. Maybe I run out soon. Maybe Faye should go down and make another drink and put a bit of splash of rum in the coffee. What do you reckon, Faye? Or whiskey or something? Jazz it up a bit. Zhuzh it up.
That's the same. This mention platform. Let it go.
Yeah, let it go, Bill. And question five, what is the first element on the periodic table? What is the first element on the periodic table?
Do you want me to attempt an Irish
coffee? Yeah. Well, just coffee with some, I don't know, what, whiskey or rum?
Maybe sometime.
Well done, PDS. Faye's off to come up with some coffee/alcohol concoction. That's very exciting. Right, so we're moving on to the last round of the first half. It's cryptic Oscar-winning films. Cryptic Oscar-winning films. So I will give you the year of that Oscar-winning film, because I'm very kind, and then I'll give you the cryptic clue. Question one was from 2005. Wealthy young American. Wealthy young American. That's your cryptic clue for that Oscar-winning film. Hey. Well done, Raph. Number two is from 1981, and it is Roman Transports Alight. Roman Transports Alight. I'll bet Nicky's all over these, aren't you, Nicky? You love this cryptic stuff. My brain doesn't work very well for it. Number three. It's from 1989, and the clue is tee off and avoid flower. Tee off and avoid flower. Yeah, I would have made my head hurt too. But I'm giving you the year as well, so you could always have a guess. Oh, I think that might be that one, and see if it works out. Number four, this is a tricky, the film's not tricky, but the clue is tricky. So it's from 2000, and the clue is Pleased He Consumed Her. Pleased He Consumed Her. More coffee. That will always work. And now for five, we're going all the way back to 1939. And the clue is disappeared on a gust. Disappeared on a gust. That is the first half done and dusted. So let's do the answers and have a tot up and see how everyone has done in that first half. So it's out of 35. Right, opening assortment. The last one, 1939, I think it was. Yes, 1939. Oh, number four. Number four was 2000. 2000. Right, opening assortment. A woman has two X chromosomes, two. A 7-inch record made 45 revolutions per minute. The vertical stripe, the middle vertical stripe on the Belgian flag is yellow. The ambassador of the Bahamas to Japan was Sydney Poitier, and Spock's blood is green. Geography. Piece of shallow salt water separated from the deeper sea by coral or sand is called a lagoon. state capital of Louisiana, Baton Rouge. The U.S. state capital known as the Mile High City is Denver. The capital of Croatia is Zagreb. The highest mountain in Japan is Mount Fujiyama, or Mount Fuji. You can have either. They're the same thing. Mount Fujiyama or Mount Fuji. Right, the audio you heard. The first jazz one was Herbie Hancock. Number two was Sonny Rollins. Then the musicals you heard. Number three, Kiss Me Kate. Then four was the musical Can Can. Five, the artist was Jackie Wilson from the 60s. From the 70s, Althea and Donna. From the 80s, Hall and Oates. From the 90s, George Michael. From the 2000s, 50 Cent. And from the 2010s, Justin Timberlake. Food and drink. So Americans call it an eggplant. In the UK, it's known as aubergine. Zucchini in the US, courgette in the UK. Tempura is best associated with Japan. Mocha is flavoured with chocolate. And blinis, stuffed pancakes, best associated with Russia. I know you didn't. Don't worry. I know you didn't mean to. Right. Infrared light has a wavelength that is too long to be visible to humans. A heptagon has seven sides. That's all right. It's all good. 2 miles is longer than 3 kilometres, but only by 218 metres. So it's fairly close. Small bones that make up the backbone are called vertebrae. And the first element on the periodic table is hydrogen. Right, these cryptic Oscar-winning films. So 2005, Wealthy Young American. That was Million Dollar Baby. 1981, Roman Transports Alight, Chariots of Fire. 1989, Tee Off and Avoid Flower, Driving Miss Daisy. 2000, Pleased He Consumed Her, Gladiator. 1939, Disappeared on a Gust, Gone with the Wind. Nice one, Auntie. So, there we go, it's the first half, 35. Oh, wow, look at this. Look at what his face done, look. You see that? She's gone for it. Woohoo! Nice. Come on, Andrew. It's a game of two halves, remember? I'm going to get this all over my mush.
And so I got your spoon.
Ooh.
Enough whiskey in there.
Yeah, that gladiator one was good, didn't it?
Oh, well done, Jerry. Oh, guys.
Damn you. Right. So we're moving on then. We're moving on to the second half. And the second half starts with a round called Sporting Cheats. I know, that's what I'm thinking now. I'm going to drink it. I'm going to get it all over my mush. So, question one. Ben Johnson was banned for drug use and had his earlier world record rescinded and his gold medal taken back from which Olympic Games? Ben Johnson was banned for drug use and had his earlier world record rescinded and his gold medal taken back from which Olympic Games? What are you putting in? Whiskey or rum? Whiskey.
Whiskey.
Oh, it's got whiskey in it. Oh, beautiful.
Is there enough whiskey in it?
Yeah. Ooh. Plenty of whiskey in that. Yeah, cheers. It's good. Question two. Name the drug cheat who won and was later stripped of all 7 of his Tour de France victories. Name the drug cheat who won and was later stripped of all 7 of his Tour de France victories. It's the best I can do, I'm afraid. Obviously, I don't do accents, as you can see.
Cheers, Nicky. Mm. And Ramon. I think it was...
It's probably a single malt.
Yeah.
Question 3. Fred Lortz, L-O-R-Z. Fred Lortz was a marathon runner who crossed the line first in the 1904 Olympic marathon in St. Louis. Why did he not win the gold medal? Fred Lortz was a marathon runner who crossed the line first in the 1904 Olympic marathon in St. Louis. Why did he not win the gold medal?
Coffee. My first.
Oh, question 1. Ben Johnson, banned for drug use and had his earlier world record rescinded and his gold medal taken back from which Olympic Games?
It's my version of an Irish coffee.
We do. It'd be good to get these things two-way. God, you imagine though, it'd go on forever, go on all night. All the rabbiting. Question 4. Banned for life in 1994 from the US Figure Skating Association after pleading guilty to involvement in the attack on fellow skater Nancy Kerrigan. Who was she? Banned for life in 1994 from the US Figure Skating Association after pleading guilty to involvement in the attack on fellow skater Nancy Kerrigan. Who are we looking for? Yeah, no, exactly. Don't know Lauder's Scottish whisky. Cayman probably knows it. Probably got several bottles. Yeah, no, that's true. And finally, Tim Donaghy. Tim Donaghy was jailed for 15 months for betting on games he officiated in and supplying information to gambling syndicates. In which sport was he a referee? Tim Donaghy was jailed for 15 months for betting on games he officiated in and supplying information to gambling syndicates. In which sport was he a referee? Fake. I can't imagine it, Andrew. Right, well, we've got a wipeout, haven't we? So this is a wipeout round, and it is the first 10 countries of the world to appear in alphabetical order. So like with all the wipeout rounds, you don't have to answer. I don't need you to get them in exactly the right order. But for every one that you write on your sheet that I have on my sheet, you have a point. So you can get a maximum of 10. But if you get one wrong that's not on my sheet, you wipe out. Simple. So have a go at that. See how you get on. I'll play you some music while we wait. And you have until the song runs out.
As long as there are stars above you, you never need to doubt it. I'll make you so sure about it. God only knows what I'd be without you.
That's good.
If you should ever leave me, oh, life would still go on, believe me. Show nothing to me.
Let me get out my red card.
If you should ever leave me, the life would still go on, believe me. The world could show nothing to me, so what good would living be? God only knows what I
There you go. That is the time out for the Wipeout. Moving on. Now, this won't be everyone's cup of tea, but we have to remember that we have all sorts of people joining. This is primarily for my mum and dad. Gardening. Question one. Which flower's name comes from the ancient Greek word for star? Which flower's name comes from the ancient Greek word for star? Question two, what is pomology the study of? What is pomology the study of? Question three, what is the national fruit of India, Pakistan, and the Philippines? It is the same fruit. What is the national fruit of India, Pakistan, and the Philippines? What as in what? That was question three. What is the national fruit of India, Pakistan, and the Philippines? Question four. A helianthus is another name for which flower? Helianthus is another name for which flower? Yes, they do, apparently. Countries have national fruits. Who'd have known, eh?
What's that fruit?
Yeah, what's the national fruit of the UK? Okay, the national fruit of the US. What's the national fruit of the US? Is it like cranberry or something? And question five, vanilla flavouring is derived from which flower? Vanilla flavouring is derived from which flower? Could be apple, yeah. Yeah, could well be.
Mm.
Right, okay. So, here we go on a picture round. So we're moving on to a picture round. So I'm just going to click off us and click the pictures. He says, hopefully this works. Okay. Here's my pictures. Oh, I've done it all in alphabetical order now. Look at that. So annoying, isn't it?
Mm.
Okay.
Maybe.
No, that's fine.
Is it minimised at the top? I mean, is it at the top green and red? Is it that?
Yeah. Just bear with me. Right, thank you. What is that up there anyway?
I don't know.
It should definitely, we will get there.
They're there, aren't they?
Yeah.
Oh, hide from...
Well, that's there, isn't it?
that's what happens.
Andrew!
He's there! The lights are on. Oh. It was all going so well.
Yeah.
Yeah,
so they're all there. I've saved them all.
Yeah, they're all in properties. And there's a green and red. Yeah, you do need to rehearse this before the quiz. That's what Andrew said. Yeah.
All right. I don't know what I've don't know why it's not.
Oh, do you have them in OBS sources?
Yes, I do, yeah. Yes, yeah. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, it's darkest night. Get your night vision out. They're all definitely there.
Yeah, they're all there.
Yeah. Let's pass back for a second while we see if we can work out what quiz pictures.
You can see Ian's a stressful, concentrated face.
Mm. Oh, well. Oh, look. It's, yeah. We'll have that next week then, shall we? Damn. Damn. Let's see if...
yeah, they're definitely in properties.
It says no source selected. All right. All right, well, look, let's not dilly-dally any longer. I will carry on. Boo. So the picture round is not there this week, so unfortunately you will get that next week. We're moving on to a round called acronyms. Acronyms. Question one, ADHD is an acronym for what? ADHD, Alpha, Delta, Hotel, Delta, ADHD. No, it's not the round for you. That's really frustrating, that, isn't it?
It worked last time, didn't it?
Yeah, it did.
I suppose that's really simple. We can't even turn the computer off and put it back on again.
No, we can't.
It usually works. No source selected. That's what it's saying, Andrew. No source selected. Have you put them in the right area?
Well, that's the question, isn't it?
Sort of.
Question two. AIDS. AIDS. AIDS is an acronym for what? AIDS. Maybe. Let's just everybody just chills out there for a second. Let's just see, yeah? Are we doing this?
What?
Points like Skittles.
Some things in life are bad. They can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, don't grumble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps, just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing. Ain't
always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the right side of life.
Right, moving on. Can't get the pictures this week. I will get Andrew and he'll help me. Next week, we'll get it sorted. Oh, you can't get the staff some days, can you? Question three. The CCU in a hospital is which department? The CCU in a hospital is which department? What does CCU stand for? Blessed are the cheesemakers. Question four. Epcot. E-P-C-O-T. Epcot, as in the Walt Disney theme park in Florida. What does Epcot? Copt stand for? You're not the only one. There's others in there that are waiting for those medical questions.
Wow. Whoever gets that one then.
Yeah. Well, we learned that. I've no idea. I had no idea what Epcot stood for, but there you go. And finally, do you know what the acronym SIM stands for? As in SIM card that goes in your phone.
Wow.
Right, and we're finishing with history. Shame the pictures didn't work. Never mind.
Next time.
Yeah. Right, history. Question one. Which country was ruled by the Romanov dynasty from 1613 to 1917? Which country was ruled by the Romanov dynasty from 1613 to 1917? Question two, which Axis power changed sides during World War II, declaring war on Germany in 1943? Which Axis power changed sides during World War II, declaring war on Germany in 1943? I hope Doc Holliday is still here, because this next question could be just up his street. Question three. Which notorious gang were involved in the famous gunfight against the Earp brothers and Doc Holliday at the OK Corral? Which notorious gang were involved in the famous gunfight against the Earp brothers and Doc Holliday at the OK Corral? Question four. Which 1873 repeater is known as the gun that won the West? Which 1873 repeater is known as the gun that won the West? You probably got that gun, CT, haven't you? Yay! He was still there. And question five, Haile Selassie was deposed in which country? Haile Selassie was deposed in which country? That is the last quiz question this week. Okay. Well, shall I do the answers first, though, yeah?
Yeah.
Right, here we go with the answers. For the second half, sporting cheats. So Ben Johnson had his world record rescinded, his gold medal taken back from the 1988 Seoul Olympics, 1988. The drug cheat that won the seven Tour de France's and had them stripped, Lance Armstrong. Fred Lortz, the marathon runner who crossed the line first in the 1904 Olympic marathon in St. Louis, he didn't win the gold medal because he was given a lift in his manager's car for 11 miles. Damn cheat. Glitcher. Damn strafing glitcher. Question four. The skater that was banned for life was Tonya Harding. And Tim Donaghy was jailed for 15 months. He was a referee in basketball. Right. The alphabetical order, first 10 countries in the world, wipeout. So those 10 countries are Afghanistan, Albania, Algeria, Andorra, Angola, Antigua and Barbuda, Argentina, Armenia, anyone sweating yet? Australia, Austria. That is the top, the first 10 countries in the world in alphabetical order. Point for every one of them. If you've got one on your list that I haven't read out, 0 points. for that. Big cross through it. But point for each that you got right. You didn't need to answer them all, as I said. Right, gardening. The flower's name comes from the ancient Greek word for star, is aster. Aster. Pomology is the study of fruit. The national fruit of India, Pakistan and the Philippines is the mango. Helianthus is another name for the sunflower. And vanilla flavouring is derived from an orchid. Ah, oh, the picture round, it's not there, boo. Acronyms, ADHD, Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder. Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder, AIDS, Acquired Immune Deficiency Syndrome. The CCU is Coronary Care Unit. Easy for you to say. EPCOT. That stands for Experimental Prototype Community of Tomorrow. And SIM stands for Subscriber Identification Module. Right, the history. The Romanov dynasty ruled Russia. The Axis power that changed sides in 1943 was Italy. The notorious gang that were involved in the famous gunfight, the Clantons.
Not the Clintons, the Clantons.
The 1873 repeater known as the gun that won the West was the Winchester rifle. And Haile Selassie was deposed in Ethiopia. So, in total, 65, because we lost 10 points from the pictures. Boo. So how did everyone get on? And sorry there were no pictures. I will get it fixed. Promise.
For life is quite absurd, and death's the final word. You must always face the curtain with a bow. Forget about your scene. Give the audience a grin. Enjoy it. It's your last chance.
Dave, you need to get out more.
So always look on the bright side.
Really good. Sam needed the pictures, didn't you, Sam?
Before you draw your terminal breath.
Life's a piece of shit when you look at it. Life's a laugh, death's a joke, it's true. You'll see Andrew. It's all a show. Keep them laughing as you go. Just remember that the last laugh is on you. And
always look on the bright side of life.
That's decent, Raph. 23. You already have usurped all of your Ghost Recon comrades. Fantastic. Yeah.
Yeah.
We're awful. And there was no art, so no excuses.
I'm here to do some more art.
Yeah, yeah. Decent. Oh, fantastic. Look, thank you so much, everyone, for coming. We have a really great community. Really appreciate it. We had a lot of fun. Sorry we didn't have the pictures, but we'll fix that with Andrew. I have got some really good pictures, so I'll get it fixed for next time. Thanks, everybody. Have a good week.
Have a good one.
And we'll catch up with you soon.
Yeah.